Kol Halayim Yahawa Bahashim Yahawashah Wahar Rakar Kwadash, meaning all praises to the Most High in the name of His only begotten Son, Yahawashah, and the Holy Spirit.
Double honor to the men who taught me this truth, the apostles and the elders at Great Millstone, who always rule well and teach well, to my fellow laborers that's continuously prophesying this upcoming destruction of this wicked kingdom America and bringing this good news of the coming of the only Savior of the elect of the nation of Israel, Yahawashah, and all fear, Shalom. And the Most High through His only begotten Son, all right, Yahawashah, has shown us mercy, has shown us favor, all right, in this gross darkness, in this time where knowledge, all right, of Yahweh Bashem Yahawashah, all right, and the knowledge of this King James Version, all right, is very, very scarce, okay? The 100% doctrine, the 100% truth, all right, of this Bible, all right, the 100% truth, all right, of the Most High and His only begotten Son, Yahawashah, all right? He has been merciful, all right, to the men that He has woken up, all right, to this truth, all right, and allowed us to get this truth, all right, in this gross darkness, all right? This is the book of Sirach, chapter 2. Verse 18, saying, we will fall into the hands of the Lord and not into the hands of men. For as His majesty is, so is His mercy. And that's right. All right. Because the Most High through His only begotten Son, Yahawashah, has had great mercy upon us. All right. Because we understand this King James Version. All right. And we understand. All right. We understand what road to take. All right. That leads to salvation. And that road that leads to salvation is doing this work, all right? Once we receive these gifts, okay? And that's what we have, nothing but gifts from the Most High, all right, through His only begotten Son, Yahawashah, supping with us, all right? This is the book of Romans, chapter 6, and verse 22. Shalakim, the book of Romans, chapter 6, and verse 23. And it reads, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of the Most High is eternal life through Yahawashah Mashiach, our Lord. All right. And He has gave us, all right, that gift, all right, through Yahawashah Mashiach in these end times, in these times where the Most High is finna send His Son to judge the earth. All right. We have the gift of faith. All right. And that faith that we have, all right, is the faith in our Lord and our Savior, Yahawashah. All right, something that the rest of the world don't have. All right, and that leads to what? Eternal life. Okay, let's get the book of James, chapter 1, verse 17. And it reads, every good gift and perfect gift is from above. All right, this perfect gift that we have, this perfect gift of faith and our Lord and our Savior, Yahawashah, all right, comes from up above, comes from the Most High power, all right, and cometh down from the Father of lights, which is the Most High Yahweh, all right, another name for the Most High, all right, it's the Father of lights, all right, or the Father of spirits, with whom is not variableness, neither shadow of turning, all right, so the Most High doesn't change up until this upcoming day that the Most High may allow us to face in this upcoming seconds, upcoming weeks, upcoming months, if it's in the will of Yahweh Bashem Yahawashah for us to face it, all right, He's not going to change, all right? So every great gift, all right, every good gift, every perfect gift that men have, all right, and those men that believe in Yahweh Bashem Yahawashah have, all right, comes from the Most High. All right, we didn't receive these gifts on our own. All right, so indeed the Most High is merciful. All right, but He's only merciful, all right, to His men. He's merciful to the ones, all right, who fear Him. All right, and He has gave us that beautiful gift of faith through His Son Yahawashah. All right, let's get the book of Ephesians chapter 2. In verse 8. Matter of fact, I'm gonna start at verse 7. That in the ages to come, He might show the exceeding riches of His grace in his kindness toward us through Amashiach Yahawashah, all right? And these are those ages to come, all right? This current 2018, all right? He has showed us the riches, all right, which is the true understanding, the knowledge and wisdom, all right, of the King James Version, all right? That is his grace and his kindness towards us, all right? He allowed Yahawashah, all right, to suffer what he had to suffer when he was a man upon the earth, all right, in order for us to receive, okay, these exceeding riches, all right? That's the grace of the Most High. That's the mercy of the Most High, all right, bestowed upon us. So I'm going to read it again, Ephesians 2:7, that in the ages to come, he may shew the exceeding riches of his grace in his kindness toward us through Amashiach Yahawashah. Verse 8, for by grace ye are saved through faith, all right? That's that gift, all right, that the men, all right, that's calling upon Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahawashah and going out doing the work of Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahawashah, proclaiming the downfall of America, all right, giving 2/3 their judgment, all right, in these heathen nations, storm with Esau, Edom, giving them their judgment out on the highways and byways and hedges. We are the men, all right, that the grace of the Most High, all right, is upon, all right, and he's bestowed faith upon us, all right, and faith through his grace, which is his son, Yahawashah, all right? Ephesians 2:8 again, for by grace, all right, ye are saved through faith, all right? We are saved through faith, all right, through believing in our Lord and our Savior, Yahawashah, and that not of yourselves, all right? So this is nothing that we've done, all right, to receive salvation. It's nothing that we've done, all right, to receive these marvelous riches, because we all broke the law, statutes, and commandments, all right, of the Most High, all right? But through grace, okay, a selective men upon the planet, all right, are receiving these gifts of the Most High through his only begotten Son, Yahawashah. And that not of yourselves, it is the gift of the Most High, see? Okay? So all these things that we have, all right, number one, faith in our Lord and our Savior, Yahawashah, all right, is the gift, all right, from the Father of Lights, okay? And that shows the mercy of the Most High, all right? So let's read the book of 1 Peter chapter 4 and verse 10. And it reads, as every man hath received a gift, even so minister the same one to another. All right, so if you have this gift, all right, and every man doesn't have this gift, all right, only the elect, all right, the hopeful elect, all right, of the nation of Israel has this gift, all right, this gift of faith through our Lord and our Savior Yahawashah, all right. And once you receive this gift, all right, the gift of this 100% doctrine, all right, you can't sit on it, all right. The scripture said it's better for one to give than receive. All right. This is 1 Peter 4:10 again. As even many have received the gift, even so minister, and minister means to serve, the same one to another, as good stewards of the manifold grace of the Most High. And that's what we should be, great stewards of the manifold grace of the Most High. All right. By going out on the highways and byways and hedges. All right. Compelling the elect of Israel to come back in, and once again condemning this kingdom America with the words of the Most High's mouth, which are these scriptures, all right, giving 2/3 of our people their judgment, and starting with Esau, Edom, and the rest of the heathen nations their judgment, all right? That's how we be good stewards, all right, of the manifold grace of the Most High, all right, because he has bestowed upon us faith. And like the book of James say, what we shall show our faith by our works. All right. And that's ministering one to another. All right. Being a servant. All right. Let's get a. Let's get the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 5 and verse 19. And it reads, every man also to whom the Most High have given riches and wealth. And that's right. These scriptures All right. The truth of these scriptures, all right, through our Lord and our Savior, Yahweh Shai and the Holy Spirit, are the true riches and the wealth of this earth. All right. Not these carnal riches, and have given him power to eat thereof. All right. We're eating the bread of life. All right. And only we only have received that power. All right. To eat the bread of life through, once again, our Lord and our Savior to die, to become that sacrificial lamb, to shed blood for us to be able to eat that bread of life, all right? Or to be able to have the power to eat thereof. And what are we eating? Once again, the bread of life, all right? Which leads to salvation, which also is another gift, all right? From the Most High. Reading on in Ecclesiastes 5 and 19, and to take his portion, to take what's been given unto you as an individual in this faith, and to rejoice in his labor, all right? And that's what we should be doing, all right? The brother Rum did a beautiful video. I forget the name, but it's some to the effect of your labor will not be in vain, all right? All right, the thing that the mission that we're on, okay, what the goal that we're working towards, all right, we're not doing this in vain, all right. And so he was saying this is not the time to be moping around, all right, and to be sad, all right. So like the scripture said, and to rejoice in his labor. So we should be rejoicing to be capable, or the Most High have shown us mercy, all right, through the gift of faith in our Lord and our Savior Yahweh Shai, for us to be able to show our faith by our works, all right, which is our labor, man. So we should rejoice in being able to labor, all right, to be able to do the works of Yahweh Shai, all right. Reading on, and to rejoice in his labor, this is the gift of the Most High, all right. This is the gift that we have, man, all right, to give diligent to make your calling and the election sure, man. All right, this is something we must rejoice in, because why? All of these are gifts from the Most High. All right. I hope this lesson been edifying. All right, and know that, you know, these are just some of the gifts, all right, that the Most High have given to his hopeful elect in these end times, and this is enough for us to rejoice about. All right. Because we know that we live in a shithole kingdom, all right? But we are the only ones that are rich upon the face of the earth. We are the only ones that have a reason to rejoice, because why? We have the mercies of the Most High, all right, stowed upon us, all right? And once we have the mercies, all right, of the Most High, he through the mercies we receive the gifts, all right? So with that, you know, Barakatay Yahweh, Barakatay Yahweh Shah, Call Halayim Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah Wahar Rakah Kodash, and double honors to my teachers, the apostles and the elders at Great Millstone, who always rule well and teach well, to my fellow laborers that's continuously prophesying this upcoming destruction of this wicked kingdom America, and bringing this good news of the coming of the only savior of the elect of the nation of Israel, Yahweh Shah, and all fear, Shalom to his elect.